We come together this evening in the presence of God our Father to celebrate this great festival of Christmas. In this service we will hear and receive the good news of the birth of Christ. And we offer to God our thanksgivings in the joyful singing of the carols. As we gather together in the name of Christ, let us pray that we may be enabled to surrender anew to God's holy wisdom, to bear the good news of God's love to a needy world, that all the people of the world may recognize their responsibility for its future and may be inspired by the message of Christmas to work together for the establishment of justice and freedom and peace everywhere. And let us pray for all in special need, for the sick, the anxious, the lonely, the fearful, and the bereaved. That the peace and the light of the Christ child may bring hope and healing to all who sit in darkness. And let us commend all whom we love, and those who have asked for our prayers, to the unfailing mercy of our Heavenly Father, as we say together that prayer which Christ himself taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
The tune said in the programme, so it's my fault to say that. The first thing was the rock and roll ritual, the first piece that I hope that you will have. I'm low 16 to playing the organ. We very much want you to sing, join in all the congregation ones. I want to delay you for one further verse, if you don't mind, once we're all over 60. The first one will be solo, second verse will be choir alone, and then I'll turn around and then you can raise the roof with your merry festive sound.
Thank you. child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onwards and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Blessed Mary. In the 6th month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man named Joseph of house David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was much perplexed by his words, and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great, and he will be called Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor, David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. Thanks be to God.
Wrapped him in bandages and cloth, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of the great joy for all the people. To you is born in this day, in the city of David, a Saviour, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was, with the angel, a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favours." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them. Thanks be to God.
In many a stained glass window sheen, from Crimson Lake to
holly in the windy hedge, and around the manor house the yew, will soon be stripped to deck the ledge, the altar, font, and arch, and pew. So the villagers can say, the church looks nice on Christmas Day. Provincial public houses blaze, and corporation tramcars clang. On lighted tenements I gaze, where paper decorations hang, and bunting in the red town hall says, Merry Christmas to you all. And London shops on Christmas Eve are strung with silver bells and flowers, as hurrying clerks the city leave to pigeon-haunted classic towers. And marble clouds go scudding by, the many steeple London sky. And girls in slacks remember Dad, and oafish lads remember Mum. And people's children's hearts are glad, and Christmas morning bells say come, even to shining ones who dwell safe in the Dorchester Hotel. And is it true? And is it true? The most tremendous tale of all, seen in a stained glass window's hue, a baby in an ox's stall. The maker of the stars and sea, become a child for me. And is it true? For if it is, no loving fingers tying strings around those tissue fripperies, the sweet and sinless things, bath salts and inexpensive scent, and hideous tie, so condiment. No love that in a family dwells, no caroling across the air, nor all the steeple shaking bells can with this single truth compare, that God was man in Palestine, and lives today in bread and wine.
Thank you. lips low and grey and threatening. Into this climate of fear and apprehension, Christmas enters, streaming lights of joy, ringing bells of hope, and singing carols of forgiveness high up in the bright air. The world is encouraged to come away from rancor, come the way of friendship. In our joy, we think we hear a whisper. At first, it is too soft, then only half heard. We listen carefully as it gathers strength. We hear a sweetness. The word is peace. It is loud now. It is louder, louder than the explosion of bombs. We tremble at the sound. We are thrilled by its presence. It is what we have hungered for. Not just the absence of war, but true peace. A harmony of spirit, a comfort of courtesies, security for our beloveds and their beloveds. We clap hands and welcome the peace of Christmas, expecting this good season to wait so well with us. We, Baptists and Buddhists, Methodists and Muslims, say come, peace. Come and fill us and our world with your majesty. We, the Jew and the Jainist, the Catholic and the Confucian, implore you to stay a while with us, so we may learn by your shimmering light how to look beyond reflection and see community. It is Christmas time, a halting of hate time. On this platform of peace, we can create a language to translate ourselves to ourselves and to each other. On this holy instant, we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ into the great religions of the world. We jubilate the precious advent of trust. We shout with glorious tongues the coming of hope. And the earth's tribes loosen their voices to celebrate promise of peace. We, angels and mortals, believers and non-believers, look heavenward and speak the word aloud. Peace. We look at our world and speak the word aloud. Peace. We look at each other, then into ourselves, and we say without shyness or apology or hesitation, peace, my brother. Peace, my sister. Peace, my soul.
So this one, ladies and gents, you get to play slightly different roles if you're a male or female. The gender stereotyping is as suspect as it is in the Rodgers and Hammerstein we're studying in Lower Sixth. So the ladies are querulous and fearful, and the gents are imperious and commanding.
Thank you. Thank you.
was promised by the ancient prophets that when the Messiah came, he would be a son of God, a wonderful counselor, a mighty God, an everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. So let us pray to our incarnate Lord, who has brought us out of darkness and into his own marvellous light. As we pray, when I say, Lord, in your mercy, we may all respond, hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, born for us, Son of God, given for us, help us to know you and to serve your kingdom of love and peace. Fill us with your spirit of truth and wisdom. Lord, in your mercy. Amen. Wonderful counselor, you order all things with your wisdom. Help us by your spirit to reveal the mystery of your love. Grant to us compassion for the weak, generosity for the poor, and comfort to the disturbed. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Mighty God, the government is upon your shoulders. So guide the leaders of the nations to bring in your kingdom of justice and righteousness. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Everlasting Father, you call us to live together in unity. Protect by your mercy all of your children. Bless our families, our workplaces, our college, and our communities. And renew in us a spirit of fellowship that we may seek a common good. Lord, in your mercy. Prince of Peace, you bring reconciliation through your cross. Now by your healing power, give to all those who suffer your gifts of wholeness and peace. Calm our fears. Rebuild our strength. Repair the broken. Connect to the lonely. Lord, in your mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the Father, full of the Spirit, hear our prayer. Receive our praise. Fill our lives. Amen.
St. John chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. St. John unfolds the great mystery of the Incarnation. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and
without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Thanks be to God.
Oh,
God, you make us glad with the yearly remembrance of the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, grant that as we joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, we may with sure confidence behold him when he comes again as our judge. For he is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, together one God, now and forevermore. Amen. Christ, who by his incarnation has gathered into one all things earthly and heavenly, grant to you the fullness of his grace and inward peace and goodwill, making you partakers of his divine nature. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest upon you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen.